While Russia continues to bombard Ukraine and its citizens,
I'm so traumatized because my relatives are in Ukraine, all of my friends are in Ukraine.
The world continues to figure out ways to force Russia to back off without escalating the war. Sanctions have already begun to stall Russia's economy, increasing pressure on President Vladimir Putin to end his attack on Ukraine. One of the biggest was removing Russia's 7 largest banks from SWIFT access, effectively killing those banks' abilities to move money and make payments worldwide.
Suppose you want to send a payment to someone in Canada, and you know their SWIFT bank number and their account number. You could tell your bank that information, and that would facilitate the transfer of funds. So it's a messaging system.
In addition to sanctions, economists say today's move to cut off exports of Russian oil is monumental.
Russia's main exports are in 2 categories, gas and energy products. And so experts believe sanctions should be targeted towards the country's largest natural gas manufacturer, Gazprom.
So when they buy oil or gas from Gazprom, they make payments in either euro or US dollars into bank accounts held by the Russian energy company. So if the intention of sanctions is to block payments for Russian gas, the tool is not SWIFT, but sanctions on Gazprom and its banking facilities.
This more direct hit on Russia's economy would have a big impact on Russian citizens, but also on President Putin's ability to finance his war against Ukraine, giving some additional hope to those who are left to suffer the consequences of this war.
I have people whom I know from Russia. It's been 10 days of war. None of them reach out to me.
Reporting from Washington, Colin Riviello, CNS TV News.